Let's see if we can make an inline 6 engine that can make well over 4,000 horsepower with a relatively small displacement. First things first, let's start with the most important part of this engine, that's the bottom end. It's going to be a 3.6 liter engine that uses VVT on all cams, quite a decider as that on plus 15, turbocharged single turbo with the twin scroll manifold on the rear side, excuse me, twin scroll housing. If you want to know more about that, I'll have my link up here at the side. We are running it on my favorite fuel, which is nitromethane, tubular race header with no cats and no mufflers. 1330 horsepower is good, but that's not where we're going. We're running into some technical difficulties with the aspiration side of it, so we'll increase the compressor housing until we don't have any more problems. Flowchart tells us the exhaust is being a problem, the compressor is being a problem, and the intercooler. Those things are severely stressed. 2213 horsepower is looking freaking awesome. Let's add more RPM to it. So I think I'm going to increase it all the way up to 9600 RPM. That's where we'll live for now. Until we have to go up even more. We'll increase our compressor size and make more boost at a different rev range than we usually do. We'll increase our spring and lift tension as well, just to have a little more boost in the cylinders and keep everything all happy. We'll also increase our exhaust side again because we're having some issues. We'll also increase our boost with our exducer or the compressor wheel, whichever way you would like to use that word. But anyway, 3600 horsepower, we are looking freaking awesome. We can increase our turbine AR housing, or excuse me, a trim level, that will give us a little more ability to make boost. And if you like boost, you would love to see more of my channel, I would recommend to subscribe and hit that like button. It always helps us out, so thank you from my side, and comment down below. What is your favorite engine type? I would love to see you guys' thoughts in the comment below. Thank you for that message. Let's get back to our video. Our horsepower number keeps increasing the more we mess with this engine, and that is going pretty darn well. We keep adding a little more. Well, we can actually reduce a little more fuel. We can increase our manifold size, excuse me. We'll also keep an eye out for our reliability, because I want this engine to be sort of reliable. We're over 4,200 horsepower, which that, in my mind, is incredible. Just because it's an inline 6 motor and it has a decent amount of horsepower, this thing is freaking crazy. Now, I can't seem to figure out why this thing is messing with us. Maybe if we turn the right settings back on, we might get back to the horsepower. 4,200 horsepower is where we're at the moment. I think we can get a little more. I do believe so. Let's go back to the top end and increase our spring lift tension again. We're up to 2.9, and we get up to 4.3, 4.4. I'm hoping for 4.4, but we'll have to see if that's a possibility. We're increasing exhaust size, so that's the diameter of the exhaust itself. You can also keep an eye out on the flow chart, what the exact temperatures are and the amount of flow that can get through there. That's decently free flow, so it's 64%. We can't really do much more with the turbocharger just because of how restricted it is in terms of the sizing. We can't go up in compressor size, but what we can do, we can maybe add a little more boost. But I think that's where we're gonna have to stop, because we're not able to get more horsepower. 4,342.9, it looks like that's our hard cap. So we're not making more power, but what we actually can do now, we can move over and do some pulls. We'll do two engine pulls, one looking at the engine, one looking at the graph. Let's see what this thing sounds like. I love the sound of inline sixes. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.